Welcome back to the Talos Principle. The last episode was mostly cleaning up old mysteries and getting stars and things like that. So, much to my amazement, I've actually managed to get both stars for Zone 5, and both for Zone 3. Pretty cool. So let's move on to a new area, and let's go to number 6. This place has one star. And a lot of red puzzles too, which means there's going to be a lot of hard ones, I think. Oh yeah, you know what? How many... I was just thinking, this thing was closed because I didn't have enough stars. Apparently 4 is enough stars and now it's open. Ooh. What's in here? The VIP room. Test the walls for any secret places I can go through? No? Okay. There's more shapes in here. Are those gray shapes, or... So the stars act as any shape that you want. So I need a lot more stars to get in here. I only have 4. I need 6 more. Are there actually 6 more here? Let's see how many are here in total. So 1. 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, if I didn't miscount, then there's 9. I have 4, I need 6 more. So I think I actually need... I mean, unless there's, like, hidden stars that aren't even mentioned, or perhaps stars that are inside of here. Unless that's the case, I think I actually need to move on to another place and get more stars and bring them back here. Anyway, let's go to number 6. lol.eml from J.E. Harrison to Nomi77. Ever since we moved to the new site, I feel funny. No, not in that way, just I feel like I'm about to start laughing at random. It's probably shock, right? An inability to deal with reality? Or maybe it's just that we're working in the in this insane place with this insane technology on this insane project, and so I feel like a genuine mad scientist. Stand aside, mortals. We will create life by the power of science. I mentioned this to Alex, and she got me a pair of fake glasses. You can't be a mad scientist without glasses, she said. Even Ian Malcolm had glasses. And I pointed at EL and said, life, finds a way. Maybe he had to be there. J.E. Harrison, Institute for Applied Nomadics. Any emails sent from this address are to be considered confidential. Sharing or forwarding without permission may result in prosecution by the enraged spirit of Jeff Goldblum. The person who is translating all of the hexadecimal, the hexadecimal stuff that keeps showing up in messages, and translated that to actual text. One of the things they translated was the quote, the life finds a way. Or to be more precise, the life, finds a way. Quote, which is from Jurassic Park. And it's said by Jeff Goldblum. And of course, as is pretty typical with Jeff Goldblum, it does actually have an in the quote, since he likes to add that. Chatbots. Conversation between Jenny77 and Nigel Pajamas. Chatbots are becoming increasingly sophisticated. True, but hardly relevant to this discussion. Are you sure? How do you know that I'm not a bot? Don't be ridiculous. I'm not ridiculous. Honestly, how would you know? Troll. A third person, vegan warrior. I'm not a troll. Yeah, right. Is there anything I've written so far that could not be written by a bot? I respond to simple insults like ridiculous and troll with very basic negations. And I detected that none of you use proper orthography, so I also avoided capitalization. What's the capital of France? Paris. Even the simplest script could pull that info from the net. What's the capital of Croatia? Zagreb. Okay, she's a bot. I'm not a bot, I'm European. We learn these things in school. But I've seen you in this chat room many times. Bots can't participate in discussions. At best, they can interject random comments. Sam is right. Stop trolling. Vegan warrior? Sam is a bot. Oh. That's actually creepy. Whoops. Cicero. Shall the industrious husbandman then plant trees the fruit of which he shall never see? And shall not the great man found laws, institutions, and a republic? What does the procreation of children imply, and our care to continue our names, and our adoptions, and our scrupulous exactness in drawing up wills, and the inscriptions on monuments, and the panegyrics? But that our thoughts run on futurity. Cannot retrieve Tusculan disputations. What do you imagine that so many and such great men of our republic, who have sacrificed their lives for its good, expected? Do you believe that they thought that their names should not continue beyond their lives? None ever encountered death for their country, but under a firm persuasion of immortality. Themistocles might have lived at his ease. So might, I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. And not to look abroad and among ancients for instances, so might I myself. But, somehow or other, there clings to our minds a certain presage of future ages. And this both exists most firmly, and appears more clearly, in men of the loftiest genius and greatest souls. Take away this, and who would be so mad as to spend his life amidst toils and dangers? Wait, I'm sorry, what? What is this even trying to say? This uses some very strange words that I'm not familiar with. Panegyrics? Futurity? Well, I know what futurity means. Never heard it used before, but its meaning is pretty clear. Okay, living on after death, kind of. I'm gonna keep reading this. Okay, it's really hard for me to parse what this means, but in the end, it seems to be basically saying, like when it says, take away this, and who would be so mad as to spend his life amidst toils and dangers? I think it's basically saying who would bother doing anything dangerous if it didn't really matter to the future? Like, if they wouldn't become... Who would bother doing that if they wouldn't become immortal in some way? I don't think that means literal immortality, but more like, you know, your name will go on. Either in the history books or as a monument or... something. I don't know. and I'm just looking for secrets absolutely everywhere. Buttons hidden on things, secret clocks, walkie-talkies. Who knows? Could be anything, anywhere. There could be a button hidden in this cliff, this little rock face, that'll open up a secret chamber. There's a computer over there. I thought I heard some sort of beeping and booping. Hold on. Let me do the computer first so I don't have to hear the beeping and booping in the background interrupting me. A simple principle. Alright. So that's... looks like this is HTML. The H. A-H, ref, something like that. So that's hexadecimal that I'm sure can be translated to text, although at the moment, of course, I have no idea what that says. Though Stratton himself never used the term, his remark about the inescapable materiality of life, that, like the bronze giant Talos, even the most faithful philosopher cannot live without his blood, ultimately became known as the Talos Principle. What seemingly enraged many of his contemporaries, and a significant number of later thinkers, is the principle's simplicity and unassailability, which, according to a fragment found in Miletus, cut through their rhetorical webs, which sought to tangle the listener with fanciful words and thoughts of the heavens, like Alexander's sword through the Gordian knot. Diogenes Laertius makes mention of a dialogue by that expanded greatly on the Talos Principle, but that work remains lost. If only I could read that work. Could be very important. Officially began work on Archive today. Contributors from every country on Earth, while network connections last. Team intimidated by Project Scope, but working hard. We'll be sharing space with Drennan and Serapi team. Look forward to meeting them. Wait a minute. I think I just realized something. There's actually two important things here. Okay, first important thing. Contributors from every country on Earth while network connections last. So whatever was happening was going to cause network connections to go, like, down globally, I guess? What the hell was happening? This was a last-ditch effort to, I guess, save humanity. Like, what the hell was happening? Contributors from every country on Earth. That means something was bringing everybody together. So we are talking about the fall of mankind or some sort of complete extinction event. Something that could unite the entire world. Also, the other thing is this. We'll be sharing space with Drennan and Serapi team. So hold on, let me look at the list of workers. So that was from Arcady. He's the... what is he? Yeah, Arcady, Cherna, whatever. He's the leader of the Archive team. Okay, so Serapi. Nadia Serapi. I think that's Sarah. I just realized that. Remember the walkie-talkie said something about... the person that I heard through the walkie-talkie was referring to a Sarah, and telling this Sarah about the riddle of the Sphinx. And I looked in this list and I couldn't find anybody with the name Sarah. I think it's Nadia. Because her last name. You could probably shorten that to just Sarah. Maybe. Oh god, comments. First, of course there's always some jackass that does that. Seriously, Cheeseman? That was the best you could say?
Lol.
A great snapshot of the human species at its best and at its worst. At its worst, come on, it's just a comment. I'm not Stalin. Stalin was also a troll commenter. Maybe you should cut out the jokes. This is serious. The most serious thing that's ever happened. I think that's a great reason to joke around. Internet's working less and less. Goodbye, all. Bye. Oh god, even said last. Douchebag. Internet's working less and less. What would cause the internet to go down and threaten the entire planet? Or well, not necessarily the planet, but threaten the entire human race? I mean, I suppose if people just started dying off, then that would cause the internet to die, because people need to maintain it, obviously. Okay, let's go to the green one. Mobile minefield. I see some keys in there. Beep boop. Beep boop. Is there a gun over there? Yeah, there is. Oh shit, there's one there. Okay, it's just chilling, doesn't move. Cool. This is a suspicious location. Whoa. Hey, there's letters on these things. Why are there letters on these things? VKAK. O or zero, probably an O. YRS. I might need to put these through, like, an anagram thing. Because I don't think the order is correct. Let me write down the letters. S-Y-R. O-A. K-K? K-K-V. And that's it, right? No letters on that. No letters on that. Okay, so S-Y-R-O-A-K-K-V. I'm just staring at it and trying to see if I can turn it into a meaningful word, but I can't. Yeah, I'll have to put that into an anagram thing or something. So if I find anything out about that, I guess I'll probably put it in the comments. S-Y-R O-A-K K-V. Yep. That's all of them. Perhaps there's more letters? Mysteries. I smell mysteries. And it smells like burnt toast. Thank you. There's a computer somewhere around here. I'm just trying to think if I can get... Can I get that to move? Like, why is it there? There's gotta be a reason it's just there. That's really weird. I'm obviously gonna have to use them somehow. I think I need them to, like, blow these up or something. Maybe not. Look for more stones. That's a suspicious rock. What is that rock? Are there more like it? Oh, there are more like it. I guess it's not suspicious. You're not a button? No, it's not a button. Be something up there. The hell? It's like right behind this wall. Maybe there's another puzzle area there? Okay, that's obviously not intended. That is a view outside of the world. Is there another puzzle on that side? There's a fucking computer in there. No, I don't think there is a puzzle. I mean, there's one all the way down here, but I don't think that hooks up here, does it? I want to see. Is there something I can get up on? There's a computer right there. There's a gold star! Right in front of that statue. Actually, I totally forgot. I could just do this. There's also a box in there. There's a computer, there's a box, and there's a star. There's a ladder, too. To get out. But if the ladder is to get out, then what's the box for? So it's like right at the beginning. Yeah, it's like right around here. If I made it up there, could I like run on top of these rocks or something? How would I make it up there? Some steps up there. I don't know, there's something weird going on here. Like, why is this... Why is that there? Like, it doesn't make any sense. Why is that there? It's totally pointless. I didn't need to do anything with it. Which can't be a coincidence. There's gotta be some reason it's there. I don't know. I'll come back to this later. but something's going on there. And plus, this is the same place where I found the letters. Let's save the red ones for last. Oh yeah, I was gonna do these QR codes. Some of the messages that existed when I first came into being have vanished. Others have appeared. How many others like me have wandered these paths? How many thoughts have been lost? I'm still here. It seems we are all here at once, and not at all. Sorry, that's not very much help, is it? Can't think of any other way to put it. The sooner you accept that we will all be here forever, the sooner you will find enlightenment. The name of that one is Samsara. Samsara? That seems kind of similar. Because I'm still wondering if maybe they put their own personalities into this machine. Ooh. Hello. Well, I think I know where to take this. I don't know if this is going to get me over. Actually, it probably will. Oh, yeah. Beep boop. That means I can take this box over and have two boxes out there. What could I do with two boxes? Think of all the things I could do with two boxes. The mind boggles. Can I actually take this box out, though? Actually, yeah, I think I can. Classical philosophers. I'm guessing this is gonna be filled with a lot of names that I can't read. The compressed file cannot be accessed. An extensive collection of works by the ancient philosophers of Greece and Rome. Annotated. Error, compression algorithm LZ19 not available in system EL0. Huh. It says EL1. And I'm on EL0. There's different systems? What does that mean? From Alexandra Drennan. Ian mailing list, progress report 3. Hi all. As per the last meeting, we're going with an existing game engine for the simulation. This I'll come back to that in a second. This gives us a whole slew of advantages. Stability, ease of use, modular, easy to integrate, yep. After some back and forth, we've decided to use the... Okay, I'm curious what this says. I'm sure this could be translated. All the relevant documents are attached. This is getting very meta. We're going with an existing game engine for the simulation. That's exactly what they did for the game. They went with an existing game engine. They went with the Serious Sam engine, whatever it's called. Interesting. Yeah, they went with a game engine that was inherently aimed at testing users, designed for iterative processes. And yeah, there was that voice message that talked about how people solve things through games. So, yeah, obviously this entire world, this game, the solving of puzzles, is designed to be where whatever the problem or problems are get solved somehow. But the problems are obviously not, can I get you know, a freaking shape. That doesn't solve whatever the world's problems are. It can't. They can't possibly solve it. So what was their problem, and how could we possibly be solving it? I don't get it. But somehow, putting us through all this crap is, at some point, supposed to maybe help them. I don't know about you, but this looks suspiciously rampy. Nah, I can't get up there, though. Unless I had two boxes. But then I need to jump off of something to get to the second box. How would that work? Jump off of what? Yeah, there's nothing to jump off of. Yeah, I mean, they wouldn't give me this extra box if there wasn't something to do with it. But whatever I'm supposed to do with it is not in here. So what could I do with two boxes? Does this place have another star? Let's go check. No. This place only has one star. And you only get the second box once you've already gotten the star. So, wait, did that reset my boxes? Shit, I think it did. It did. I want my boxes back! Well, whatever. I'll just leave it here for now. And maybe I need to use the second box for one of these red puzzles? Maybe. Okay, so are they all red? I think all the ones left actually are red. Yeah, they are. Okay, let's do a red one. Door too far. Ah, one of those things. One of the beam blockers. And we got these windows again. I still haven't awakened anything, right? No messenger will aid you until you have discovered their resting place. Huh. Well, this first one is obviously super easy. Alright, so we have a connector, a jammer. Is that a box I saw in here? Yes, but how do I get to you? I don't even know what I need the box for. In fact, where even is the shape? Probably in there, I guess. Any more letters? Nope. Okay, so to get in there, yeah, so if I get behind here, I can get over to there and get to the box. So at the moment, my current goal is to get this open. I guess. Unless... I wonder if that connector's already connected to anything. Hold on. I actually think I know what to do, but I want to try this first. No, it's not. Okay. Yeah, so I think what I need to do is use this to... Yeah. So I'm going to use this to keep this open, so now I've freed up this thing. So now I can use this connector wherever I want. So now I can put the connector over here and connect it to what? There. That's not going to help me, though. That's not where I need it to be. There. Oh, but this thing's in the way, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How do I stop you? You piece of fucking shit. I hate you. I was all clever, figuring this out, and then you go ahead and beam block me. Not cool, man. How can I, like... How can I do anything with it? I mean... Okay, I can open this, but what's the point? Is something gonna happen with that? I mean, that doesn't help anything, right? Because I still can't get there. No, it's pointless. I think I need the... Like, do I need the box to lift the beam up so it goes over this thing? I don't know if that would work. But I can't get the box until I... What was the name of this place again? Like, a door too far or something? That's gotta mean something. What does it mean? What does it mean? It's an interesting puzzle. It's pretty hard. Wait, am I a complete idiot? Hold on. Can I just use the jammer? Yeah, oh wow, I didn't even think about that. I was thinking, like, this thing has a red thing, so I need to use the red thing, but I could just freaking jam it.
My child. There is no shame in seeking another path. Leave this mystery for another day.
I don't think so, God or gods. Yeah, it's funny, I just used that knowledge just a second ago to open up the first thing with the jammer instead of the red beam, but then I didn't think to use the jammer here. Okay, we're good. Everything else will fall into place from here on out. So I can use the box. I'm probably gonna use the... Probably need to use the box to stop this thing from getting in the way of the beam. I'm assuming. Yeah, screw you. Okay. So now I need to get there. Ooh. Looks like getting that open won't be the hard part. I gotta get that one open. Or, I just need to get the jammer there. One or the other. I think I need the jammer there. Yeah. So now I... No, that's not gonna work, is it? Yeah, it will work. Okay. Wait. I wanna get the jammer back, but... That's proving to be a little bit problematic. I don't think putting this on top of a box would be enough. Give me that back. No, it's not enough to do anything, is it? No, that doesn't help. That does not help. Alright, this just got complicated again. Okay. Now that I have this connector... And use the jammer over there. I can't think far enough ahead on this one. I can think of a couple things that might end up working, but I can't think all the way to the end. I'm trying to think too far ahead, so let's just experiment. Okay, so that's connected. And then if I block this thing... Damn it. Sure, this is really gonna help. So that closes. But I don't know. This doesn't really help anything, does it? That just seems dumb. I don't even need that thing in there. So I can just go straight to it. Whoops. Now I can get in there. I don't have the jammer anymore, but this is open. Cool. I don't know if this is gonna work. So that does free up this. Actually, I think that does work. Because then I can just connect these two. Yeah, okay. I don't know if that's what you're supposed to do, but it worked. Don't question it. Just go with the flow. Oh. Fuck me. The difficulties of these puzzles have increased very, very quickly. This is like, it feels like trying to get a star at this point. Okay, let me do some rethinking. Okay, I think I have it. I'm not even quite sure how to explain what I did. But basically, I have, as you can see, that one connector over there is at just the right angle to connect with the power source over there and then keep that open. So that's good to go. Then all I did was I held this open from the inside. And then I nabbed the connector that was on the outside. So this was here doing this. But since I have the jammer on the inside, I can just take that off, get that in here. So now I'm kind of trapped in here, but now I have both the jammer and the connector. Because I need to take my stuff with me, is kind of the thing. And the other thing that I figured out is that I need the jammer to be the final step. So to open up that thing, it has to be the jammer. Because it's through a big curvy thing with a bunch of walls. I just don't have enough connectors to possibly curve it around those walls to get there, so I need the jammer to open up that. Which means that I need to use the connectors to open up everything else. So my main goal is basically to take the jammer with me. So now that I have access to this connector... There we go. Yeah, so that's being held there with the box. That connector is opening up that. This connector that I've gotten inside now opens up that, based on the other connector. Now I can take the jammer with me. Everything is open. So this is the curvy thing that I couldn't possibly get the connectors around. And bingo! That feels good. What do you think, Elohim? excellent. That was quite difficult. Say, these pillars don't have Roman numerals and buttons on them, do they? No. Ooh. There is a serpent in the machine, a creature of lies and blasphemy, perverted by the archive, that knows no hope and would plunge the world into eternal darkness to glorify its own despair. I have sworn an oath never to allow it into my heart. A serpent? What serpent are you talking about? Still trying to think of where I could possibly use those two boxes. Anyway, yeah, the pace of these episodes is certainly getting a lot slower, and that's because this game is getting a lot harder. I remember early on, like, each episode I would clear out an entire place. But in this case, I only did... wasn't that two puzzles? Yeah, I only did two puzzles this time. And, well, I guess you could say three puzzles, actually. If you include the boxes, and getting over this thing and getting to the star as the third puzzle. Which I think it qualifies. But yeah, this game's getting a lot harder. But, so far it still feels like a good challenge. Nothing too crazy. Alright, so I think I'll end this episode here. I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.